be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Jesus Christ has made peace by the blood of his cross. And once you know him, you'll never not know him. There are many people who have made a profession of faith. There are many people who said they tried being Christian, but they were never born again. They were never born of God. They were never brought to be children of God. They had an experience, or they claimed to have had an experience. But they went back to their own vomit, as the dog does. The dog returns to its own vomit. You take a pig. You take a pig out of the mire.
I tell you why.
You take a pig out of the mire. You can perfume the pig. You can put a red ribbon around its neck. But it's still a pig. A dog. A dog vomits. And the dog goes back to its vomit again. Why? Because its nature is a dog. Why does a pig go back to the mire? Why does a pig go back to the mud? Because its nature is a pig. And all those who are not of Christ, all those who are not of his sheep, they will go back like the dog and like the pig to their old ways. They go back into apostasy because they are pigs and dogs. And Jesus Christ was right when he called people dogs. He said, it is not right to take the children's meat and to give it to the dogs. And yet that humble Canaanite woman, she was not Jewish. She was not of the sheep of the house of Israel. But that Canaanite woman said, Lord, cannot the little dogs, cannot the puppies eat of the crumbs that fall from the children's table? And Jesus Christ said, I have not found so great faith. No, not in Israel. And that Canaanite woman, she was not of the lost sheep of the house of Israel. She was not Jewish, but she was saved by faith.
This is not
in Jesus Christ.
This is not
Jesus. She was saved by believing on the Lord Jesus Christ. She was saved by the free gift of God. And God saves people not by the works that they have done.
For decades.
It is not by your good works that you can save yourself. It's by the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. It's by the work of Jesus Christ that we are saved. It's not by our works, but by Jesus Christ's finished work. Because when Jesus Christ came into this world, he came to finish the work that the Father gave him to do. And that's why Jesus Christ, God, manifest in the flesh. He said, my Father works hitherto, and I work, and I work. Yes, on the Sabbath day, he healed the sick. On the Sabbath day, he cast out evil spirits. On the Sabbath day, he did many wonderful works, because he said, my Father works hitherto, and I work. The Son of God is working, just as God the Father is working. And God the Holy Spirit today is working, bringing man to conviction of sin. It's God the Holy Spirit who is reproving the world of sin and of righteousness and of judgment, of the sin of not believing in the divinity of Jesus Christ. That is the unforgivable sin, not to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God. That is the spirit of Antichrist. And the Antichrist spirit denies God the Father and God the Son.
Islam.
Who is a liar? Who is a liar?
Netanyahu!
But he that denies that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh. And to deny God the Father God the Son and God the Holy Spirit is a spirit of Antichrist.
What does this mean, Holy Spirit?
And that is why we worship the one true and living God. The only way you can worship God in the right way is coming to God through Jesus Christ. There's only one way to approach God, because God requires sacrifice. And the sacrifice, God has provided the sin. It's not your sacrifice or my sacrifice. It's God's sacrifice. And the sacrifice that God has provided for sin is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. The Korbani, the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. Jesus Christ is the Lamb of God, without blemish and without spot. There was no sin in him. In Adam, our federal head,
wait.
That's why the whole human race in Adam are in sin. But Jesus Christ is the federal head of all the redeemed of the human race. And he came to be our head. He came to be the sacrifice that God requires for sin. God provides the substitute. When Abraham offered up his son Isaac, God provided a sacrifice.
In
the place of Isaac, God provided a sacrifice in the place of Abraham's
son.
And Jesus Christ is the Lamb of God that God has provided as a sacrifice for our sin. Jesus Christ is the Korbani. The Korbani that you need to bring before God is the finished work of Jesus Christ. He alone has done all things well. Never man spake like Jesus Christ. Never man did any work like Jesus Christ. Never man raised the dead and caused the lepers to be clean. Never man caused the blind to see as Jesus Christ did. There is no other miracle worker like Jesus Christ. And all the works, Jesus Christ said, all the works that I do, they are not me, they're the Father that dwelleth in me doing the works. Jesus Christ came to glorify God the Father. He didn't come to glorify himself. He came to glorify the Father. And that's why Jesus said, the words that I speak to you, I speak not of myself. It is the Father in me that does the work. And that is why Jesus Christ, when he was asked, show us God, show us the Father, and that's enough for us. He said, he that has seen me has seen the Father.
Praise the Lord.
Praise God. Just as when you look at a television set, or when you look at your iPhone, or your iPad, or your computer screen, you see not the transmitter, not the one who's doing the broadcast, but you see the broadcast, because that's the image. That's the image. And Jesus Christ is the express image of God. He is the express character of God. That's why all we see in God, we see in Jesus Christ. All the mercy of God, we see in Jesus Christ. All the justice of God, we see in Jesus Christ. All the love of God, we see in Jesus Christ.
Right.
Because God is a God of sacrifice. God provides sacrifice. And Jesus Christ is the sacrifice that God has made for sin. God was in Christ reconciling the world to himself. And that is where we find God. You say, where is God? God is in Christ, my friend. God is in Jesus Christ. You will not find God anywhere else. Some of you believe in a remote God that you can never approach. No, God was in the flesh. God was revealed in our humanity. God clothed himself with our humanity in the person of Jesus Christ. Christ Jesus came into the world to destroy death. By death, Jesus Christ has destroyed the devil who had the power of death.
Thank you so much.
And that's why we rejoice today.
Because Christ,
when he's walking from Abraham to Jerusalem,
he is
the Lord and giver of life,
who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified. That is the Holy Spirit.